What's going on, guys? Mystic here, and I'm here with my first ever tutorial. This is on Sony Vegas. Hopefully you guys are comfortable with using Sony Vegas. If you guys do not know how to use Sony Vegas and you guys want some After Effects tutorials or something, just go search it up. Go search up optic compensation tutorial, After Effects, or whatever you guys are looking for. But this is going to be focusing on Sony Vegas because that's what I use, if you guys didn't know. And I'm going to repeat myself again. This is my first tutorial, so I hope you guys enjoy. And if you guys want me to do more tutorials like this, make sure you guys drop a like and comment on my videos, whatever you guys want me to do a tutorial on. And yeah, let's just get started here. So basically, what I did on here was just I sunk up all the beats in the song you guys heard in the beginning. So if you guys ever need to go back, just go back and look at the beginning if you guys are confused on something, or if you guys want to see what I basically did. Because I'm gonna try to stay away from RAM previewing on this, because like I said, my computer's shit, and it just does not let me RAM preview while I'm recording. Because that's what I just tried to do, is RAM preview while recording, and it's really bad. But either ways, we're going to get started here. You don't need any plugins for this effect, which is great. So don't worry about that. So all you're going to have to do is go down on the video effects and find pinch slash punch slash punch. Jesus Christ, I said that so weird. Either ways, you're going to scroll down once you click on pinch slash punch. Just scroll down and go to reset to none. So you're going to drag and drop that on the part you want it to start on. So basically I wanted the effect to start from 7 to 9, and this is where the shot is on kill cam. So this is where I wanted the effect to take place between these beats over here. So I just drag and drop reset to none on there. I already have my own preset, so it doesn't really matter. You can have your own presets and stuff, but you're gonna click animate right here. And then on here, on the first clip right here, the first keyframe, you're gonna leave that at 0 right here where it says amount. Leave that at 0. So hopefully that says proportion, like make sure that that's checked. I think that makes it like fuck up or something. But this part, it doesn't really matter. This is just gonna be when you want the effect to start. It could be starting later or earlier, so it doesn't really matter. It's just how much keyframes you want it before the effect starts. So it could be like 5, it could be 2, it could be none, it could be 7. I usually stick around 5, so it doesn't really matter. It's just up to you guys. So since it's still at 0, I don't have anything added. I could just click on this one, it'll just add a keyframe. And so these two keyframes are just going to be 0, so this is where the effect isn't going to take place. But once it passes this fifth keyframe, it's going to start the effect wherever you have it located. So if you guys don't want the effect to just start right away, so basically I want this, I want to right click on it and make this a slow fade, so it, everything looks a lot nicer. And this beginning one is just going to be smooth. It doesn't really matter, but I like to make it smooth just in case, so it looks nice. So nothing should be happening now. You guys shouldn't have anything. Everything should stay at 0 on both keyframes. And then towards the end right here, I'm going to click on this keyframe where the effect is going to end. I'm going to make this 0, and I'm just going to click on add keyframe. Since everything is again still 0, you're just going to add that right in. And this, I'm going to right click on it and make it smooth again, so that both of these ending keyframes, like the beginning and the end, are smooth. And then right here, it's again up to your choice on what you want it to be. We're going to do the same thing right here, but backwards. So since this I have on the fifth keyframe from 0 to 5, I'm going to make this one 4. So this one's a little shorter, so I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 back. I don't know how I'm going to be doing these tutorials. I hope I could make them and please you guys with tutorials, but my computer is actually disgusting, so it really glitches out on everything. But right here is where the effect is going to start. So these two in the back right here, so the back and the beginning, these the keyframes like are basically the ones that are just going to be 0, and they're going to be in the outsides. And then the middle ones right here are going to be where the effect starts. So once you get to the keyframe you want it to start on and then end right here, I did 4 since this one, the beginning one, is 5 frames away and this one's going to be 4. You're going to go to the amount and you're going to click on whatever amount you want it to be. So if it doesn't have the negative, it means that it's going to kind of pop out. But if you have the negative, it's going to pop in, which is what we're going to try to do here. So I usually like to put it at around 700 to 800. It could be 9 if you want it. It really is up to your choice again, but I like to keep it at around 700 800 900, around there. So you're just going to enter right there, and we already have this effect going on right here. So again, like I said, it's up to your choice on what you want it. The more you go down, the more it's going to pinch like inwards. So if you kind of look at the preview screen, like that's at the max where it's going to just pinch in all the way, and you can have it kind of just like a little more a little pinch in, but not that much, and it's all up to your choice. It could be like a nice smooth pinch in, or it could be a really like huge like pinch, which could look really good in your edit. So like I said, it's all up to your preferences. So I'm just gonna keep it around 700. Doesn't really matter. There we go. I'm just gonna keep it at that. You guys could keep it at whatever you guys want it to be. And on this keyframe, I'm gonna right click on it, and I'm gonna make this a fast fade, so that this part, the keyframe where the effect actually is placed, is gonna be fast, and then where it says zero over here on the five frames away from the beginning is gonna be slow. So it's gonna go from slow to fast, so it looks nice and smooth, and then the back frames, the ones that are zero on both sides, are gonna be smooth. So it doesn't really matter, but I'm pretty sure it makes a really big deal in your edits, because if you kind of look at it without it being like smooth and it looks like linear fade, if you click on that, it's going to make a big difference. That's what I kind of notice. It won't look as good, but if you kind of add in those fade effects on some of your effects, it'll just look a lot nicer and smooth. So there we go. It's really it, I guess. The effect isn't really that hard. You guys can add in different things onto it. You guys can add in blurs. You guys can add in effects. It doesn't really matter, but it's a really simple effect, to be honest, if you guys didn't know how to do it. I was kind of having a little bit of trouble on it, but you guys could just get creative with this effect. It's not really that hard. A lot of these effects are out there right now, but a lot of people do them differently. Like, if you guys know who Kitty Edits is, he's my father. He does Sony Vegas too, so if you guys don't know who he is, go check him out. Oh my god, his edits are fucking... I love his edits, that's all I'm gonna fucking say. But either ways, he does it differently. If you guys didn't know, he got, like, hacked and his channel got taken down. He used to do it by going to Magic Bullet Looks, which is a plugin you need to download and install into Sony Vegas, and he went into the effects, and you could do it like that. But this way is kind of like a, I don't know how to explain it, like a little more pinch in effect, which is nice too, but both ways are nice. So if you guys want to see that way, there's a lot of other like effects. Like, people have kind of done the same tutorials. But yeah, like I said, this is the effect I did in the beginning. So if you guys want to see what it looks like towards the end, I basically did it all the same. That's how it should turn out. And yeah, so hopefully I didn't mess up on this tutorial. I did stutter a lot because I haven't made a commentary or talked in a video in months. And I want to apologize on that. I'm sorry, because I've been focusing on editing a little more, and I've been designing and all that. But hopefully I can start getting into more tutorials, like after this one, make more and make more commentaries and all that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please drop a like and a comment. Doesn't really matter. I don't know what I'm saying. This is the part where I start to mess up on a lot of my shit. But yeah, before I mess up even more, I'm gonna just peace out. So yeah, it's been Mystic. Bye.